in the second part of the video on the topic training and development of the course Human Resource Management. So in this part of the video, we'll discuss about the concept of management development, then management development methods. We'll also discuss about the differences between training and development that we have discussed in the first part also, but here we'll thoroughly discuss about that, and also we will discuss about the evaluation of training and management development. So what is management development? Management development is a systematic process of training and growth by which managerial personnel or the employees gain and supply skills, knowledge, attitude and insight to manage the work efficiently and effectively. It can be, you know, initiated by the organization or the manager himself or herself. It is a long time training for self-development. It has broad areas of concept with comparisons to training, and the focus here is on the development of the hidden potential of the employees or the managers or the personnel to prepare him or her for a potential responsibility. The management development programs are essential because of the reasons, like first one, maybe the managerial personnel need to develop as they are to solve various problems of technology, adoption, production, sales and marketing, competition and etc. Then the second one would be business and industrial leaders are to, you know, involve in social and public responsibilities which require broader outlook to the part of the management. Then the third would be business executives have to develop themselves for handling problems arising out of increasing size and complexity in the business environment. The fourth one would be the relations between the management and the labor are becoming increasingly complex. So to maintain employee-employer relationship is must, and therefore management development helps in this regard. The business executives are to, you know, understand the macro environment components to make them aware about the changes in the public policies, then the concepts of social justice, economic environment in the foreign countries, and expertise the manager role in foreign nations and etc. Then a sound program of management development has to be based on the development of concepts evolved in the program. Then management development is not at one time affair, but it is a continuous process throughout the executives or the employees' career. Then increased understanding of others' behavior and attitude helps in managing and contributing to managerial development. Then peaceful and relaxed atmosphere helps development. Then clear-cut objectives and goals are necessary for the development. Then participation is essential for their growth. Then a feedback from all the levels of management, right from the top to the bottom one, are necessary to overcome the shortcomings of the employee. The development can be expected from the responsibility of the personnel department, and the management development must relate to all the managers of an organization. Now let us discuss about some of the management development methods. So it is very important to improve the efficiency level of the managerial levels employees, and on the job management development methods for managers would include number one, the job rotation. So job rotation means transfer or change of department by the managers. The trainee tries to learn the functions of the concerned department by actually performing it, whether it is sales, production, finance, etc. Then coaching. In this type of training, the employee gets an opportunity to work directly with the senior manager. Then there are some of the other job management methods, or you know, methods, or even we can say management development methods for the managers. They include case study. In this method, a written description of the organizational problem is given, real or hypothetical. So this case study has been already discussed in the first part of the video. Then there comes the management games. So this method is very popular when the trainees are divided into groups of five or six. Each of them competes with the other in an artificial created marketplace. So each group may be allowed to decide how much to produce, how to maintain the inventory. So this kind of activities are happened in management games. Then there is also role playing, which I have already discussed in the earlier video. That is, it is a method where realistic situations are created, where the trainees are to observe the roles and try to, you know, understand the real life situation in a workplace. Again, there is seminars and conferences. Seminars are organized so that the trainees get an opportunity to interact with the experts and that they try to solve the different managerial problems. Now let us discuss some of the difference between training and development. So the major difference between training and development is in respect of the level of the employees for whom these are meant and the contents and the techniques employed to them. So by training, we already discussed in the first unit, it is an important short-term process of utilizing systematic and organized procedures through which non-managerial persons, you know, acquire technical knowledge and skills. And by development, we means it's a long-term educational process utilizing a systematic and organized procedure, and it helps the managerial personnel to understand conceptual and theoretical knowledge. So dear learners, you can see here an outline of the difference between training and development. The first point says that training generally imparts specific skills to the employees. Development is more general in nature and aims at overall growth of the executive. Then training is concerned with the maintaining improved current job performance. Development build up and competencies for the future performance. Then training focuses on today's needs and development leads to tomorrow's result. Training is short-term perspective. Development is long-term perspective. Training is job-centered in nature. Development is concerned with the nature. Then training is task-oriented. Development is skill-oriented. Then the role of trainer or supervisor is very important in training. And in case of development, all development is self-development. And the executive or the managerial personnel has to be internally motivated for the same. In training is divided into three groups: workers or operative groups, supervisory groups, and management group. On the other hand side, development methods are related to position, rotating training, then conferences, services, and etc. Now, dear learners, let us discuss about the evaluation of training and management development. So each training program should have provision for evaluation as a part of planning. Otherwise, the management or the organization cannot be sure that they are doing the right thing and that the management are not wasting much time, their valuable time and money of the organization. There are some criteria that can be used to evaluate the training and management development programs. Number one is the reaction of the trainee. Whether the trainees like or unlike the program, whether they are satisfied or dissatisfied with the program. Then learning, whether the concept, ideas and principles of the training are helpful to them, are helping them in the helping the participants. Then the behavioral changes, whether training program, you know, changes the behavior of the people, we can say that the training program was effective or is effective. Then impact on the organizational effectiveness, whether the modified behavior caused positive result, such as, you know, increase in the output, improvement in the quality and reduces in the cost. So after evaluation is made, the situation should be analyzed to find the possible causes for difference between the expected and the, you know, actual outcome. And some necessary measures should be taken in designing and implementing the future training programs. So dear learners, with this we have come to the end of this video, which is the second part of the video. And here we discussed about the concepts of management development, its method and the evaluation of training and development. With this, I would like to wind up this video. Thank you so much for watching this video.